نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك، وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه، أرسله المولى سبحانه وتعالى بالهدى ودين الحق يظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافر. أما بعد، إخوة الإسلام، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى المولى سبحانه وتعالى، وهو الذي أوصى عباده المؤمنين في كتابه المبين، فقال سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the greatest book of His books, and He sent to us the best of His messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. And He was the best example and model for the perfect human being in his character, in the way that he's dealing with people, giving us the best example to human being to live on the face of this earth. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned to us that the believer always love and be loved. The believer always loved, that means love others, care about them, and also he be loved by others. That means if you find somebody that people hate him for any reason, that there is, that means there's a problem with him. Especially if most people they dislike him. How can we open the hearts of the people and get to their hearts so they love us, they respect us? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us the best example. And the Sahaba, the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they learned from him. So they were the best examples after him. And through studying the seerah of the Prophet, studying the teaching that comes through his sunnah alayhi salatu wasalam, we can derive from this certain keys that we may use to open the hearts of the people. And today, inshallah, we'll mention some of these keys. But keys will not work unless you use it. It's not enough to know the keys, to have the key, unless you use it. Same as if you have the key of the door. If you didn't use it, will not open. Same of the hearts of people. So there's a list of these keys. I will mention only few because of the khutbah, not take that on time. Let's start with this. To know the character of the believer. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي تَوَادِّهُمْ وَتَرَاحُمْ وَتَعَاطُفِهِمْ مَثَلُ الْجَسَدِ إِذَا اشْتَكَى مِنْهُ عُضُوٌ تداعى له سائر الجسد. بالسهر والحمى متفق عليه ريبورتد باي البخاري ذا مينينج ذيس حديث which was rated by نعمان بن بشير رضي الله عنه said Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said the likeness of the believers in their mutual love mercy and affection is that of the body when one limb of it complains the rest of the body react with sleeplessness and fever look to this specific example how much the Muslim care about his brothers and from here we know that we need to have these keys so we show real care and love for our brothers in Islam the first key smiling face smiling face you know this is one that the Prophet ﷺ told us 1400 years ago now people they know from their studying the psychology that they use this tactic to attract people most people who use it these days are business people so they can sell their products this is what they call it business smile sometimes it's not real but just to attract people so he can sell it. But here for the Muslim is sincere because Muslim never seen others قال عليه الصلاة والسلام لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا ولو أن تلقى أخاك بوجه طلب the meaning this hadith do not belittle any good deed don't think that it is very little it's nothing do not belittle any good deed even meeting your brother with cheerful face a cheerful face smiling face another hadith the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said وَتَبَسُّمُكَ فِي وَجْهِ أَخِيكَ صَدَقًا and your smile for your brother is a charity you are rewarded just to open this two lips show your teeth with a nice beautiful smile for your brother was an easy way to get more deeds and you know the day of judgment everyone need one hasan one good deed that even the son will ask his father and the father will ask his son give me only one and everybody will not give it up at that day so we should care about Look to the example of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jabir ibn Abdullah said, since the time I accepted Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never once failed to notice me. Whenever he saw me, he would smile at me. All his life, whenever he met the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he always the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم with all the troubles that he faced all the difficulties that he faced but still keep his smiling face for his followers the second key السلام greeting and greeting in Islam has deep meaning it's not just hi good morning good evening It is a meaning of peace. Peace with mercy, with blessing. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Look to this beautiful greeting. And the Prophet ﷺ commanded us that we meet our brothers with salam. And it is reported that one of the signs of the end of time that people only care to say salam to people they know And this is what we see these days. You meet some people, look at your face, no, I don't know this guy. So they will not say salam. لا حول ولا قوة. But the Muslim should say salam to anyone. من عرفت ومن لم تعرف. The one that you know and the one you don't know. Say salam. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, listen to this hadith. لا تدخلون الجنة حتى تؤمنوا ولا تؤمنوا حتى تحابوا أولا أدلكم على شيء إذا فعلتموه تحاببتم أفشوا السلام بينكم. The meaning, you will not enter paradise until you believe, and you will not believe until you love each other. So, loving each other is a sign of what? Of faith and belief. And then, the Prophet ﷺ said, shall I show you something that if you did it, if you did, you would be love each other, spray salam among yourselves. Salamu alaykum. The third key. Visiting your brother in Islam. Visiting. Unfortunately, these days, even relatives, they may not visit each other. Even sometimes, the father or the children, they don't visit their parents. Most people are busy with these devices. They call it social communication. But in fact, it is cutting the social communication. In reality, because the communication was before people visit each other, now they just care by sending a message. Or if it was more better, they will call. And that's fine. It's better than nothing. But visitation is one of the good things. Just imagine when your friend, your brother, call you and he said, I miss you. I didn't see you for a long time. I would like to visit you. Just imagine what you're getting. You will think, well, if this brother, he doesn't care about me, he will not visit. And look to what the hadith said here. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us an example of a man who visited his brother in other city. I'm not going to just to save time to read the hadith, but I'll give you the translation of the meaning. He said, a man set out to visit brother, his brother in Islam, in another town, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent an angel on his way. When the man met the angel, the latter asked him, where do you intend to go? He said, I intend to visit my brother in this town. The angel said, have you done any favor to him? He said, no. I have no desire except to visit him because of love, because I love him for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there the angel said, I am a messenger to you from Allah to inform you that Allah loves you as you love him. Love, you care about your brothers, Allah care about you. The fourth key, gift. Giving gift, especially in certain occasions. When your neighbor, your friend, they got promotion, you get married, for any occasion, in Eid, and you take very simple gift. Some people, they think gift that should be expensive. It's not, the value is not in the price of the gift, but the concept itself of caring and gifting others. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, تهالوا تحابوا. Give each other gifts and you will love each other. Also, somebody give you gift. That means he care about you. What do you think you're feeling about him? You will hate him? Or you will love him? You will think positive about him. You will think, how can I return his favor? The fifth key, which we'll conclude with, is to be always kind nice, helpful to other people. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أحب الناس إلى الله أنفعهم للناس. The Hadith said, the most beloved people to Allah are those who are most beneficial to the people. The most beloved deed to Allah, listen to this, the most beloved deed to Allah is to make a Muslim happy. To make a Muslim happy, this is a great deed in the sight of Allah. And when it's considered as a great deed, that means will get you back with what? With great rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or to remove one of his troubles, get difficulties from inside. Or to forgive his debt. If he is in debt and he cannot give it back to you, and Allah gave you enough money that you are not in that need, and you said you excuse him. Or to feed his hunger. And then look, listen to this, my dear brothers. The Prophet ﷺ said that I would like to walk with brother regarding need is more beloved to me than that I seek myself in this mosque in Medina for a month. Just think about this. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us that you just walk, maybe it will take you 5 minutes, 14 minutes, 1 hour, walk with him to help him to get something. That means help him, maybe somebody who doesn't give him his money back. Help him to finish any of his needs, because he has a problem and you go walk with him to help him, to support him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, it is more dear to me that I go with him than staying in this masjid, which is the Masjid al-Nabawi, which is the salah, 1,000 times. For how long? To stay in the masjid for a full month in i'tikaf. This to show you how much it is important, how much it is great to care about other Muslims and to be very helpful, very very beneficial to them. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an wa nafa'ni wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayat wa al-dhikr al-hakim. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم الجليل لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا كما ينبغي لجلال وجهه وعظيم سلطانه. My dear brothers, in these days, as you see, unfortunately, the enemies of Muslims, they strive hard to divide us, to put a lot of borders, obstacles between among them. And the Muslims should be very wise. We should turn to the Quran. The Quran said, "Inna akramakum 'inda Allahi atqakum." The best among you is the one who is best in piety, pious people. The Muslim never ever look at the norms of nationality or race or location or any other thing. The most important, the one in front of you, he's a Muslim, he's believing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, believing the Quran. This is the one that we need to care and be close to him. No matter where is he from, from the east or the west, from my country or not, the most important is the love among the Muslims. And when the Muslim, they wear one hand, one heart, no differences among them based on any other rules other than what was mentioned in the Quran, which is taqwa, then the Muslim will come and lead the world again as they did before. The most dangerous weapon in the hands of the enemy of Islam is not nuclear. It's none of their weapons. The most dangerous is the differences among Muslims. They use it. They manipulate Muslims. They divided them. So you will find Muslims are busy, unfortunately, fighting each other while their enemies, they are taking over. So my dear brothers, from this hadith we know that it is very important to spread love and respect and care in all Muslim communities. And we should care to return to the teaching of the Quran and the Sunnah and follow the example of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in dealing with our brothers in Islam. Last word that I would like to say, that unfortunately some people, they are good and nice, but unfortunate to other people outside. But when he go home, for his wife, for his children, they will see different face. Believe me, many messages that, you know, scholars and students of knowledge receive from women, they are crying of the way their husbands deal with them. They said, some of them, they said, he is always in masjid. He always with cheerful face. He's always, when he meet his friends or guests, he is considered as the best. The people, they said, what lucky your wife is. But when he closed the door and enter, they will be different. Yes. Different face, roomy face. This is not correct. Because your relative has more right in your kindness. And this is why the Prophet ﷺ said, خيركم خيركم لأهله وأنا خيركم لأهله. The best among yourself is the one who is best for his own family, his wife, his children. And then he said, I am, the Prophet ﷺ, to encourage us, I am the best among you for my family. So my dear brothers, we should care about taking also kindness and smiling and good treating for our family, same as we care about showing our kindness to other people outside. إِنَّ اللَّهُ مَلَائِكَتُهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين واحمي حوزة الدين، واجعل اللهم هذا البلد آمنا رخاء سخاء وسائر بلاد المسلمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم آمنا في أوطاننا، وأصلح أئمتنا وولاة أمورنا، واجعل ولايتنا في من خافك واتقاك واتبع رضاك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم وفق إمامنا وولي أمرنا، وخذ بناصيته للبر والتقوى ومن العمل ما ترضى، وفقه لما فيه خير البلاد والعباد برحمتك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ارفع الضر والبلاء عن إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان، ارفع الضر والبلاء عن إخواننا في سوريا وفي العراق وفي بورما وفي أفغانستان وفي مالي وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارفع الضر والبلاء عنهم، اللهم ابدلهم بعد خوفهم أمنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم عليك بأعدائك أعداء الدين،
من الكفرة والمنافقين. اللهم احصهم عددا واقتلهم بددا ولا تغادر منهم أحدا بقوتك يا عظيم ويا جبار يا رب العالمين. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروا على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.